Operation Maelstrom.
Hello out there, and welcome to another episode of Greetings from Derbyland, the only online internet web series that knows nothing, Jon Snow. I'm the New Jersey Knight.
I'm the voice of Virginia, KVD.
And we are here to talk about the always ready red wedding events that are taking place in our little section of the map of Derbyland, hopefully a larger, broader section of the map of Derbyland as Season 2 goes on. And speaking of Season 2, Episode 4.
Already. Kind of a month in.
A month in, already there, and kind of something new for us. Usually we go all over our region of the section of the map of Derbyland. We go here, we go there, whatever. But we always go hit one spot.
Yeah. Not this week.
Nah.
No, this week we went everywhere. We went to Harrisonburg. We went to Richmond. Two different days, two different cities, two different bouts. Really good bouts for a ton of reasons on both parts. We're going to get to that here in a moment. But I had a question for you.
Mm.
What are the two things that a man should never do?
Let's see. Take out the trash and never make the bed.
I don't necessarily know that that's accurate.
Oh, it's a single. Hey, how about that?
But according to our sponsor for this week's episode, it should be never go into a woman's purse and never go to her salon. We're talking about these guys right here, 18-8 Fine Men Salons opening soon in Waldorf, Maryland. Soon being at some point this summer, our good friend, what do we call him, Han Solo, if he's married to Princess Sleia?
I guess so.
I like it.
Yeah. He's got to have the pirate mustache. He is a mangly pirate. So,
that
yeah.
is true. And it is a gorgeous mustache.
It is.
But he's opening this shop here soon in Waldorf. He was kind enough to sponsor the series for multiple episodes this season. So we wanted to go ahead and throw this one out to him. This is his episode. So again, 18-8, opening soon in Waldorf. As we have more information on it and when we have a date, we'll communicate that on. But thank you. Thank you very much to, we'll call him Han Solo, because I don't know if he has a derby name. I'm going to throw that into the comments today. Come up with a derby name for him. It's Chris Simpson. Look him up. Come up with a derby name if he doesn't already have one. And if he does, come up with one anyway, because it's fun.
Yeah.
But we went places again. Where was it?
Yeah.
Where did we go first?
I really don't remember. Now I do. Harrisonburg.
Oh, yeah.
A.K.A. Rocktown. Rocktown.
Feel like I've seen them somewhere before.
I think
before.
It's over here somewhere, up around my head.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, those guys. And gals.
Yes.
Mostly guys.
Mostly guys.
A couple guys. Mostly guys. But we went down there. We covered Rocktown Rollers versus the Black Rose Rollers Roten Cherries, which is a lot of R's all over the place. It's the Battle of the R's. Who's going to win? We're going to go to some bout footage now. All right, in this jam, we have Ramsey McDirtbag, friend of the show, wearing the star for Rocktown.
Wearing the star for the Roten Cherries, Bad Wolf.
Yes, Bad Wolf. Oh my God, what about
it? Yes, you'll be hearing her name very soon.
Quite a bit, most likely. As we get going here, this is the B team, I believe, for the Black Rose Rollers.
The travel team, yeah.
Going up against, you know, with this team, with Rocktown, a lot of changes in the offseason. Weren't sure what to expect. What we got, Bad Wolf right there with a lead jam. And Ramsey hot on her heels.
Right on her heels, yes.
And a random person, shout out to you. And that one was quick. It was in and out. It was quick and dirty. All right, this is Iser Slam wearing the star for Rocktown.
And for the Roten Cherries, that is knockout.
Eyes are same going down there in turn one. At this point in time in the bout, Rocktown took an early lead. Definitely credit to Eyes are same lead jammer there. Early on. I believe this jam is actually one of them where she gets a little bit in before calling it off. Yeah, that's right. In and Out gets five up. As Knockout finally gets through.
Mm-hmm.
And wisely, Iser Slam's going to call this one off there with a nice little baseball slide. All right, Iser Slam again. Star 4, Rocktown.
Star 4, Rotten Cherries is Knockout.
Now this is one that's going to go the full distance. Look at that hit. Ramsey forcing her out, and everybody from all the way back to Whiskey Ginger recycling her back behind the jam line, buying some time.
Looks like Knockout attempting a star pass. Didn't feel it, put it back on her head.
Eyes are Slam, on the other hand, does get lead jammer. A nice little apex throw of her body. It's kind of a jump, unfortunately. Track cut.
Which is the reason why this is going to full two. She was lead jammer, going to the box. We go full two.
Random shout out to our boy Verbal Assault there. Hashtag Verbal Sucks.
Yes.
Make that out there. It's because we love him. we didn't create that hashtag?
No, he did.
Here we see everybody just waiting for Black Rose to get back around here. And a good three wall from Whiskey Ginger. Let's see, it was also Ramsey and, is it Executie?
Looks like it was Executie, yes.
Giving her a lot of guff on the way out there. She does put up the points, ultimately, but they held her back and bought some time. Now, at this point in time in the bout, Black Rose had already taken back the lead. And they were holding on to it.
Mm-hmm.
Even though Rocktown was chasing them the entirety of this bout.
Especially in the second half. A lot of lead changes throughout the second half.
Well, like, we were talking like 8 or 9? Something
about that in the first half of the second half.
It was just absolute chaos.
But really fun to watch.
Oh, yeah. It was one of the more fun bouts that we've seen so far this season. Iser Slam knocked out and recycled back a bit. Get a track cut called at the last second, but it does come to its natural conclusion. What a jam. GiggleHertz, wearing the star for Rocktown.
And wearing a star once again for the Rotten Cherries is Bad Wolf. And I would like to say, that bald head down at the bottom of the screen is not me.
That's true. Be one of our wonderful volunteers.
And it looks like GiggleHertz breaks on through, takes lead jammer.
She had a hell of a bout.
Yes. Six lead jams in this bout for Giggle.
She's a good jammer anyway, but just really shows it here. She puts up, what, 3-4 points before calling it off. Good move on her part. Whiskey Ginger wearing the star for Rocktown.
And once again, Bad Wolf wearing the star for the Rotten Cherries.
Let's be honest, she jammed like every other one, right?
Yes, pretty much.
Odds were in her favor, forever in her favor, if you will. Lead jammer there for her to be all over this episode. I couldn't even randomly not pull her.
Solid hit there by Bad Wolf.
Yeah, definitely a low block on Iser Slam, but I can't fault her for, you know, immediately closing up and trying to eliminate potential injuries. Is what it is, though. Smacks the pivot, trying to work her way through. It looks like we did have a star pass to Smack Mamba. And a power jam, if I'm right. Yep, there it is. Bad Wolf going to the box for a track cut.
Which was a rarity for her. She didn't go to the penalty box very often.
No, she's played pretty clean about here. But she was a lead jammer. This one's going to go the distance. We have another just under a minute left in this one as we get the star back on the helmet for Smack Mamba. And she coils and strikes right here. Breaks through a couple of them. Breaks through some more. Turn 3 puts up 5 points.
Great footwork there by Smack.
And bringing them back into the bout. Like I said, they were chasing them the whole time.
Mm-hmm.
This is a bout we found ourselves watching almost more than we were calling.
Well, it was just, you couldn't help it. It's human nature to just get into a bout that's so good.
Yeah.
And so interesting and so fun.
So close.
Yeah. I was calling with Maleficent and there were just moments of silence that We were just enjoying a really great roller derby bout.
That's right, believe it or not, we are actually fans of this too. As that one comes to its natural conclusion.
And here we have the alcoholic drink, 7-7. That's Bad Wolf for Rotten Cherries.
And Smack Mamba for the Rocktown Rollers. This is it. This is the final jam. This is what it all comes down to. And this one goes almost the distance. We have lead jammer here for Black Rose, which is exactly what they needed. They went into this jam in the lead.
But barely. It was still within grabbing distance.
Absolutely. And wisely, as you see, Rocktown never giving up. Even with this 5 points in the sky, increasing the lead here, knowing that the inevitable conclusion is that this one's going to get called as soon as time expires. Because the jam clock is going to go past the play clock. Rocktown never stopped trying to get smacked through to try to force a win, possibly. It was still possible at this point. As we're winding down to the last couple seconds of this jam, another 5 in the sky for Bad Wolf. And that was it. The play clock expired. You heard everybody shout and call it. They did, and they took the victory. We'll give the score in a second here. And that's the bout footage we have. The score,
that'll be the Rocktown Rollers 176 and the Rotten Cherries 185. 9 points. 9 point difference. Came down to that last jam. Oh, really, really, really great bout.
Yeah.
A lot of fun to watch.
That's one I'm probably going to be going back and just rewatching the bout footage myself. Just I ended up shooting this one, and it was a blast.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's really no way to put it.
Just to do a quick tally here, we had GiggleHertz with 6 lead jam, Iser Slam with 5, Bad Wolf with 12, and Phoenix from Rotten Cherries with 5.
And Giggles giggling all the way.
All the way. Just giggle, 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 giggle.
That's how you can actually hear her coming up. That's her tell.
Giggle, 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 giggle.
But we do have some interviews from this one, so do you want to go do that?
Yes. To the wall I go. I'm here with the MVP blocker, number 0, Knockout. How are you doing today?
I'm very tired, but good.
Yeah, because that was a very fast, very physical bout.
It was.
And it was very, very fun to watch. Since it's your first time on Greetings from Derbyland, give us the secret origin of your derby name and number.
Well, my actual name is Katie Olenek, and it kind of got shortened to KO. And as I was going through fresh meat, it turned into, oh, you got KO'd, you got hit, you got knocked out. So I embraced the name.
You definitely embraced the name out there several times. A lot of hard hits.
Thank you.
Is this your first bout for the season?
No, we actually just came off of a win 2 weeks ago against 301, who was another Greek group of ladies. They played a very tough physical game, much like these ladies did tonight.
So what are some things that you do in the off season to kind of keep your derby legs going?
Just stay on skates. You got to stay on skates. If you take those off, you lose your legs, you lose the strength, you lose the mindset. So you got to stay on skates.
All right, we'd like to end here on a fun one. Why number 0?
Actually, my number was KO, K0. And then when the numbers changed, I just dropped it to a simple 0.
But she's not a 0, folks.
No survivors.
She is your MVP blocker for the Rotten Cherries Knockout. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys.
I'm here with the MVP jammer for the Rotten Cherries, Bad Wolf. How are you doing today?
I'm awesome. Feeling fantastic.
You look a little tired.
A little bit.
You jammed quite a lot, and I think, from what I remember, 12 lead jam status.
Woo! That's how I like it.
Since it's your first time on Greetings from Derbyland, what is the secret origin of your derby name and number?
My derby name, Bad Wolf, is a Doctor Who reference, and my number, N7, is a Mass Effect reference.
yet another Whovian. What are some things that you do in the off season to work on your footwork?
Our league has practices all off season. They're terribly grueling, but you go and it keeps your endurance up.
Do you, some other ways that you keep your endurance up for anyone who is just starting to want to maybe try a roller derby or try jamming, what are some tips that you can give them?
Squats, a million squats a day, a million.
I cry at the word squats, so I don't even want to do that. I don't even want to think about it. We'd like to end on a fun one here. You said physics. What part of physics do you like?
I'm actually an AP physics teacher, so I love teaching physics to high schoolers.
Has a high schooler come in and said, I saw you play roller derby the other day?
Nobody's seen me play, but they have found me on the internet, which is awkward.
It might be, but just tell them I'm doing something awesome here. Awesome lady right here, MVP jammer for the Roten Cherries, Bad Wolf. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm here with the MVP blocker for Rocktown Rollers, Executie. How are you doing this afternoon? It's still sunny outside.
I'm tired, but it was a great game.
You, when your name was announced, you went nuts. Is this your first time?
My first MVP blocker. I've never gotten an MVP award before.
We were here to be the first, to show you the first time Executie got MVP. Since it's your first time on Greetings from Derbyland, give us the secret origin of your derby name and number.
17. I've always played under 17 when I played soccer, when I played basketball for one season. Clearly, I have no hand-eye coordination, so I don't do that anymore. But Executie was, I was trying to come up with a couple of different names, like Southern Ballista or Polycyanide, and Executie just seemed to stick, except I don't get called X, I get called Cutie. So.
Well, come on, she's a cutie. So, yeah. Take us back to the bout. What were some things that you did to make yourself a more effective blocker?
I've really been working on that backwards blocking and trying to get those jammers to one side or another and then give them a little punch out or a little hip out. And so that's what I've really been working on this season. It seemed to pay off.
Yeah. How did you do some things to keep your blocking chops on the off season?
What we do is we do a lot of work. We really have a 2-week off season over the holidays, and then we come right back into it. So for me, I do swimming, and then on Sundays we do this hardcore workout that's outside. It's all like running and hard P90X stuff.
Again, tears just came down my eyes because of all that exercise, and I just can't. We'll end on a fun one here. What is your favorite video game franchise?
I love Blizzard.
Blizzard?
Yeah, World of Warcraft.
Yep.
Yeah.
How often do you play some WoW?
Well, I haven't played in a little bit, but you know, I'm going to get back into it since it's summer coming up, so I'm excited.
Yeah, don't go outside where the nature is or anything. No.
Just play some Overwatch. It's going to be great.
It's time to just completely veg out and be one with the couch.
Well, no, we're going to play Derby.
That too. Excuse me. Did you see that face that I just got? I'm not going to sleep tonight, but this is your MVP blocker, Executie. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Look who's back here on Greetings from Derbyland. This is GiggleHertz, your MVP jammer for the Rocktown Rollers. How are you doing tonight, lovely?
Pretty tired.
It was a very fast bout, very hard-hitting bout. But what were some things that you did in the offseason? Because you were very, 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 very fast. What are some things that you do in the offseason to keep your speed up?
So as much as I hate running, I've been running. Look at that. And it definitely helps keep the cardio up, and it helps keep going, because that was a long game. Many, many jams happened. Many back-to-back jams happened. So yeah. It definitely helps with that.
I saw that. You were a jammer. Got called off, and you're like, no, I want to do this again. I could do this again. And you did, and you got lead jam the next time.
Thank God.
So, yes, it's derby season, but it's also hockey playoff season. It looks like, please tell the audience at home, who's your team?
So I was born and raised in Tampa, Florida, so go Tampa Bay Lightning! Woo!
How infectious is that? That is just so adorable. I don't mind the Lightning. That's fine too. Yeah, you know, but you know, my team's horrible, so I'll pull for some Bolts.
Yeah. Might as well.
Yeah.
I mean, made it to the second round. Just chilling, waiting.
Waiting for the next round. Your MVP jammer. Isn't she adorable? Look at that face. Look at her personality. Look, isn't she lovely?
I wish I could do a cartwheel on skates, man. Next time.
Yet on our show. That's going to happen. GiggleHertz, everyone.
How was your trip?
It was good. Dark, moody.
Sounds about right.
Yeah.
Par for the course. So, yeah, again, those were Great interviews, I assume, because that's all we provide here on Greetings to Derbyland, is the absolute best interviews as perpetuated by us and nobody else. It's just how it is. We are the authority on our own interviews. We do have more interviews today and more Bout footage. But first, do you find yourself in limbo looking for new nerdy shirts or, say, coasters or journals, or now in limited quantities they have tote bags and hoodies, of course? I know I do. And really, the best place to go is to click the link in the description below in the show notes and use the promo code GFDerbyland at RIPT Apparel, my sponsor for my wardrobe this season. This shirt, which is a combination of the game Limbo and Legend of Zelda, because they're both awesome. This was purchased there. You can't get it. It's only available for 24 hours. Means by the time I got it, you already couldn't get it. By the time it's filming, you can't get it. So you have to go to their site every single day. 24 hours these tees are up. You may be able to get them for a little bit more the next morning for a first couple hours for the last call, but that's about it. If you want to get these, go to rippedapparel.com. You can get them for 15% off. Use the promo code GFDerbyland at checkout. Remember, Ripped Apparel, the best pop culture tees.
So that first Bout was one of two.
Yes.
Hashtag one of two.
Yes. And so this next one was the hashtag two of two that we randomly used the next day, which you may have seen some of this Bout footage already, because we ended up kind of last second live streaming it on my Facebook page.
What happened was River Shady tried to stream, something happened, and it just didn't work. So we were like, hey, let's test it. You never know.
Yeah, you never know what a live stream of a Bout could... Why would we ever want to do that on Greetings from Derbyland? But for a non-live stream, let's go to some more Bout footage. All right, we have Pixie Pistol wearing the star for Southern Maryland.
Ruby Rottweiler wearing the star for River City.
That is a mouthful to say, isn't
it? It is. A lot of R's. And as we were talking about the R's, takes the inside track lead. Jam 1 of 6 for Ruby.
Ruby, the most epic hair in all of Derby.
Mm-hmm.
It's true.
Even though she doesn't think so, which...
I don't understand.
I don't get it.
If you hear that voice in the background, by the way, 5 points on the board, as you can tell by Admiral Mayhem's graceful palm extension there. The voice in the background that you hear is our good friend Billy Flynn, the voice of RCR. Another 5 in the sky for Ruby here. Pixie struggling to find her footing here early on, and I stress early on. A couple new faces there. Kenya from SMRD, this is her first Bout ever. Oh, a little hop and a baseball slide and calls it off. A little bit of flair from Ruby Rottweiler. All right, Juicebox, we're already in the action here. We're in star for SMRD.
And Cindy Boohoo. Meaning the wrong end of Carbomb. Carbomb had to go to the penalty box for it, but like all Derby players, worth it.
I think she's pretty happy with this. Juicebox just snakes on through there, gets the points, calls it off. From out of nowhere!
Out of where?
Nowhere! Ruby Rottweiler wearing the star for RCR.
Juicebox up for SMRD.
And Ruby right there on the inside, turn one, lead jammer. Juice having a little trouble getting past Thor. She does eventually as the pack is destroyed a bit. Takes another hit from Audacity on the way out. And gets a lead.
No, gets a power jam there.
Yeah, power jam, sorry.
So this is going the full two because Ruby was lead.
And Blue being thrown at her by Thor as if she was Mjolnir. it's just the only way to describe that. Blue is used as a weapon. Blue does, unfortunately, serve time in the box. His juice is recycled back. Good credit here to RCR's defense for holding her as much as they could before she snakes on the outside and puts up a couple points there. As the power jam is just ending, and Ruby finds out why, Rach says no. Juice knocks to the inside. Thankfully, no zebras were harmed in the filming of this. As Thor goes to the penalty box, and Juice squeaks on through. Another couple points on the board for her. Same for Ruby. Barely on the inside of turn one. After a nice little sizable hit there, I think it was from Kerry Chaos. And Ruby snakes right through there, puts up some points as Juice gets recycled back. And the jam is getting ready to come to its natural conclusion here. In just a couple seconds with an apex jump from Ruby Rottweiler, unfortunately to the outside. Pixie Pistol wearing the star for Southern Maryland.
And Heroin Bob in her predatory stance as she is wearing the star for River City.
Heroin Bob, who we are only recently being able to recognize outside of her face paint.
Yes.
Sorry, Bob.
As Pixie Pistol takes lead jammer right there, 1 of 5 for her. But unfortunately for every lead that she took, hot on her heels was a River City jammer.
It's good on both these leagues. Credit to both sides. I mean, at this point in time in the bout, Southern Maryland had come back into the game, thankfully.
Mm-hmm.
Carbomb Kelly wearing the star for Southern Maryland here.
Cuntree Jam wearing the star for River City.
That iconic Cuntree Jam three-point stance. But look at that defense from Southern Maryland holding her up until she was able to get back up in there. They weren't able to recontain her, but they bought their jammer time to get their intake lead. Carbomb gets through, calls that one off. Pixie Pistol once again wearing the star for Southern Maryland.
And Audacity wearing the star for River City.
A look at this only can be described as a kerfuffle in turn one that just right before RCR could get through, right before Audacity could, Pixie takes lead jammer, and they both break against the levee around the same time as each other. Audacity, one of those jammers that you just kind of forget how fast she really is. Mm-hmm. Pixie put up 5 points there on that pass. So Audacity gets through, puts up another 4. But it took her almost half the track to get through Smurd's wall there. And a nice little inside on turn 3 for Pixie, putting up some more points. This is definitely an increase in defense for Southern Maryland in this bout versus the previous one that we yes. covered just 2 weeks ago.
And as we see Pixie Pistol on her way to the penalty box, since she was lead jammer, we're going full two.
This week's episode brought to you by Full Jams.
Yes.
Apparently.
Quite a bit of them.
Kenya attempting to recycle Audacity back. Audacity in a power jam here. Looking for a little bit of help from her friends and comes up against the force of General Sleia, who knocks her out in her famous walking you out the door move. She's a good hostess.
She is, even though it wasn't her venue.
Didn't matter.
Still a gracious hostess.
Audacity does eventually get through there, putting up 5 points. As that power jam did end. And the jam comes to its natural conclusion. Alright, we have Stormy Vixen wearing the star for RCR here.
Pixie Pistol wearing a star and taking lead jammer.
One of many times for her. She's really coming to her own.
Absolutely,
this season,
yeah.
Especially.
We got to see a few other jammers for RCR because of some concussion protocol for Cuntree Jam and Ruby Rottweiler, so it opened up some opportunities for other jammers to try, see how they did. And Stormy Vixen did very, very, very well in the second half. 3 lead jam status.
putting up some points for her team.
And we'll say, thankfully, both those jammers that we mentioned were fine.
Absolutely fine.
Ultimately. Can't be too careful.
Can't be too careful, but they are hard-headed, so.
That's true. Especially country.
Yes.
And that's the bout footage for that bout. RCR versus Southern Maryland.
Hashtag 2 of 2.
Yes. And score for this one?
Score for this one. River City Rollergirls, 434. Southern Maryland Roller Derby, 93.
So a bit of a point spread, but I think at this moment, the best thing to say for Southern Maryland is now that they are a full-fledged member league of the WFTDA, a lot of it is just trying to increase skill and focusing on different things for each bout. That's what it kind of sounded like to me when I was talking to their coaching and training a bit after the bout. And in a lot of respects, from what you see from episode 2 of this season to now, there's a lot of things that changed for the better 2 weeks later. That's good. That's very good on Southern Maryland's part. It's always good to see leagues that are up and coming, especially when we happen to have nothing but love for one of them. In this case, both of them in this bout. River City just, they're turning into a force in our region.
They really are. Some stats here. We got Cuntree Jam taking 8 lead jam status. Ruby Rottweiler taking 6. Audacity taking 4. Cindy Boohoo taking 7. On the Smurd side, we got Carbomb Keller with 3. Bix a Pistol with 5, and Juicebox with 3.
Juice, another player that had a much better game this time around. And it was just good. I think maybe getting out there in the mix and blocking a little bit kind of worked for her. Because she does kind of like to get a little intense on the track. And she showed it, which kind of seeing some of the footage we showed, that the rest of it that we've seen that I shot, she can mix it up as a blocker too, and that's good to see. We have some interviews from this one too.
I think so.
So, you gonna go do those?
Do I have to go back to the wall?
Back to the wall. Okay. Dun, 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 dun,
dun, dun, dun, dun, dun, dun, dun, dun. Yet another familiar face to greetings for Derbyland. Princess Slayer, MVP blocker for Southern Maryland Roller Derby. How are you? How are you doing today?
Tired.
You look it. It was a pretty tired thing. No, I'm getting a kiss here. Yeah. I never worked so hard for a kiss in my life. I'll take this and put it in my pocket. In the off season, what were some of the things that you did to keep yourself in derby shape?
I started eating better. So during the off season, I actually didn't do a lot. I played with my kids mostly. But I started more of a paleo type diet, I guess you could say. Tried to get rid of all my processed foods and got back on my Herbalife nutrition plan, which has been amazing, actually.
Yeah,
made a huge difference.
And it definitely shows, definitely quicker, peppier out there from last season that I saw you. So you definitely, it definitely shows.
Older, like, but stronger.
Like, and on a fun one, the last time you were on, we talked about episode 7. Now that we've both seen it, what'd you think?
Oh my god, it was awesome. And it's out on, and I haven't watched it again the second time, but I need to. I need a Star Wars watching party.
Second time? Like, I saw that at least 3 times in the theater.
Some of us don't have that kind of free time, because, you know, we're training and stuff.
I don't have free time either, and I'm doing this, so yeah. MVP blocker for Southern Maryland Roller Derby, Princess Sleia. Thank you.
There you go.
First time on the show, MVP jammer for Southern Maryland Roller Derby, Juicebox. How are you doing today?
I'm doing good. I'm here. I'm alive. I made it through. That's what matters.
Since it's your first time on Greetings from Derbyland, give us the secret origin of your derby name and number.
The number is my son's birthday, so April 20th. So 420, that is my number. And the name Juicebox, which has been shortened down to Juice, basically comes from my son, too. When I started playing derby, he was 2 years old, and I wanted a name that kind of, like, reminded me of him. And he's loves juice boxes, and he was a toddler at the time, and I wanted something, like, cute and kind of unsuspecting. Mm-hmm. So that's what I went with. It reminds me of my son when I'm always on the track, and, you know, I'm, in his eyes, like, you know, oh, mama has muscles and mama plays sports and he thinks it's so cool. So that's where it comes from.
It is really cool. Take us back to the bout. This is your first MVP?
No, I've been MVP before, but that was like in the prior season before I took my break last year.
Okay.
So this season, first MVP.
Yeah, I know. And it showed. You definitely had several lead jams out there. What are some things that you could tell fresh meat that are thinking about joining roller derby, how to stay on their feet, how to get better feet as a jammer?
My best advice is, honestly, you just need to have heart because you're going to get knocked down a lot. Mm-hmm. And so you got to just kind of, will yourself and have the inner strength to, get up no matter what. It's not about a skill, because I sucked when I started, and I still feel like I suck sometimes. But it's just about, literally pulling your spirit together and your insides and just getting up, putting your feet underneath of you every single time you fall down. Because if you do that, you'll get better.
Well said. I'd like to end on a fun one. Sometime last year, you were in a bodybuilding competition.
Yes. And I came in last place, and I've done powerlifting, and I came in pretty good for that. I came in second in my class, and pulled about 255 pounds on my deadlift, so I keep pretty active, but derby's kind of taken my heart this year, so I'm really focusing on this for the time being.
Well, that's good. What a thing to give your heart to. We've given our heart to roller derby.
I know,
and it's fantastic. Your MVP jammer for Southern Maryland Roller Derby. Juice box, or now just juice. I'm going to stand up straight now.
That's
thank you. I'm here with a familiar face for greetings from Derbyland, your MVP blocker for the River City Roller Girls, BlaxicanNinja. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm doing all right. I'm still working out this mic thing. Usually I just talk, but, okay.
You got all fancy now, right?
Well, we try to be fancy, and sometimes we succeed and sometimes we do not. Since this is still the beginning of your season, what are some of the things that you did on the off season to keep yourself in the derby shape?
I don't know. I came in practice. I mean, we still had practice, so that's pretty much, unfortunately, that's all I did.
But it definitely showed. It definitely showed you had some massive hits out there today. It was some blood curdling hits that I like to say. But it was really fun to see. Let's end on a fun one here. You said your sport's basketball. Who's your team, and who are you pulling for in the playoffs?
Florida State football. That's my college football. That's my sport. But for the playoffs, definitely Miami Heat. That's my team. So hopefully, they pull out this year.
Think they got a chance?
I think they have a slight chance, a little bit. I have hope. I'm hopeful. So hopefully.
I'm a Knicks fan, and I've been hopeful for my entire life. So that will never happen. I might as well just keep on being hopeful. Your MVP blocker for the River City Roller Girls, BlaxicanNinja. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yet another familiar face to greetings to Derbyland. Your MVP jammer for the River City Roller Girls, Cuntree Jam. How are you?
Doing well, thanks. How are you?
This is my first time to interview. You had some other guy interviewing you last time.
Who was that guy?
Many times I've heard that, who is that guy? And I'm like, I don't know. He follows me around. I just have no idea. What are some things that you can tell some fresh meat or anyone who wants to get into roller derby, some things to do to get yourself in roller derby shape?
I'd say do a lot of HIIT training, which is high intensity interval training. And I also think it's important to express that derby is a very mental game as well. Mm-hmm. So prepare yourself mentally. You have to believe in yourself, have confidence in yourself, and be willing to push yourself to a point where you didn't think you could ever make it.
You are named Cuntree Jam, so you love yourself some country. You love the country. What is your favorite part of just acres upon acres? What is your favorite part of that?
My favorite thing ever is fields of sunflowers. I know it sounds lame, but it's true. They're my favorite flower. So,
your ideal backyard would just be sunflowers.
Just everywhere.
Just everywhere.
Yep.
Just
yes.
Fields and fields of sunflowers.
Maybe some chickens and pigs in there too, but.
Hey, chickens and pigs. Hopefully they don't eat the sunflowers. Remember, kids, say it how she says it. Don't spell it how she spells it. Your MVP jammer for RCR, Cuntree Jam. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right, that's enough of that because
we don't want to lose our partner status.
No.
So, once again, good interviews?
I think so. And before we get to the conclusion of our episode, while we were at Rocktown, another team, two teams that we love very, very dear to our hearts, Nova taking on Southern Delaware. Final score for that, Nova 110, Sodell 180.
Wow.
Mm.
That's not necessarily the point spread I would have expected. I can't say that I'm sad I missed that bout, because I am. I wish I could have seen it. But at the same time, we also saw excellence.
We saw in Harrisonburg. We saw a great bout and hanging out in Harrisonburg.
At the Golden Pony, which always they're not a sponsor. I'm just going to mention that the food, specifically the Samuel L. Chicken that you saw me post on our Instagram, which if you're not following us,
get on it.
Fix that. But the Samuel L. Chicken is great. And I've legitimately been craving it ever since. I really want to get that again. I'm going to wait till what? October 1st?
Yeah. Or we have an open invite to go tour some breweries up there with some Rocktown. Mm. Some Rocktown rollers. We might have to.
Well, if the hand could get on that, wherever that thing has been for the last couple episodes, if you could get on that and make that happen, that'd be fantastic.
Yeah.
Hand is our assistant there. Yeah.
Thank you.
Good hand. I definitely wanted to mention the Golden Pony. That was on my list of things that I kind of forgot to mention. Because we're on episode 4, about to do episode 5 in a couple days from this taping. That will be our final episode before Coastal Chaos, the first of the two epic tournaments that were involved in this season. So far, knock, knock, knock. With this one, of course, I want to mention that this is brought to you by the Rock Coast Rollers. It will be streamed on Nerd Derby's channel. It's NER Derby. I'll link their channel in the show notes. Definitely subscribe, because they do bouts all over the place, including teams like Bangor Roller Derby, who's going to be there. Mm-hmm. They've done games for, let's see, Mass Attack, New Hampshire, Rock Coast, Shorepoint, Granite State, and Bay State, and this up-and-coming team I think I'm hearing a little bit about called Fredericksburg Roller Derby.
Heard some things.
Yeah, they're all going to be there. They're all going to be live streamed and with an announced team that includes people like you and I, and our head announcer, Gretchen. Have it on good authority that Beautiful Banshee will be there, and I freaking love her, and I can't wait for you to meet her. Well, she's so awesome. We got a couple other announcers that I haven't met yet and can't wait to. It's going to be a lot of fun. So definitely check that out. It's going to be May 6th through the 8th, Nerd Derby's channel. Watch the whole thing. And definitely subscribe to their channel, too, because you may or may not see some things from Greetings from Derbyland. I guarantee we are at least going to film an episode live there in front of a studio audience with some other announcers. That part of the deal is definitely done. That's going to happen.
Yeah, you know, live. Not nervous or anything.
No.
Not at all.
But we've also got August 12th through the 14th, brought to you by the Cleveland Guardians Summer Affair. The weekend of challenge bouts that just keeps on giving. So many freaking things. So many things I can't even talk to you about. Let me tell you the things that are happening already for those of you who have not seen any of the other episodes of the season, which go back and fix. They're all there. If you go back to Operation Maelstrom Channel, you can watch all of Season 1 binge watch. We've already reached that status. You should join that status. We've got Quadzilla, The Smactivist, Tink, Just Wing It, Booty Quake, Next Level, Skate Shop, Antic, and of course Greetings to Derbyland, all going to be there, advertised to be there for the whole weekend. It's going to be a day and a half of conversations and clinics and coolness going on.
Panels, booths.
We can say some extra things here in a second. I want to mention London Mauling is the one heading up the charge behind the scenes. And of course, Champ Unkind is our head announcer. He's the reason we got over there. He wanted to bring us over to announce and maybe do a little bit of Derryland. Poor guy. Didn't kind of think, nor did I, what we were actually going to get ourselves into here. But London and I and NJ have been working back and forth for a couple weeks. We can't talk about everything yet. There are still some things that are going to be happening that weekend that we cannot speak about. Soon we will give you, I'm hoping for some exclusives too.
things that we know are going to happen. We are going to film an episode of Greetings from Derbyland live in front of a studio audience at Summer Affair. It's either going to be the Saturday night or Sunday wrap-up. It's just going to come down to scheduling. We do know that we will be hosting a panel ourselves, about half hour to 45 minutes, where we will talk a little bit more about what about why we're doing this show, what we're going to be doing with it, how we've got where we are, the future of it, and taking questions from you.
They're giving us a live mic in front of people.
God help them.
Oof.
I do know that there are a couple people that we will be getting interviews with. The hope and intention, scheduling permitting, is that we will be doing these interviews. They're going to be long-form ones, like 20, 30-minute interviews, live in front of a studio audience, in front of the people there. They will eventually then come up on the Greetings to Derbyland channel as our new Power Jam episodes. And we'll roll those out as we get them completed. So we'll have those throughout the rest of the season. There's some other people who may end up coming, who may be involved, some more companies, some more things, some more events, somehow all packed into 3 days.
Still all up in the air.
Yeah, but already those things I listed off in the beginning, those are already happening. That's how much is already happening. And this is an event that just keeps growing. I can't wait.
And if you want to be there, tough. It's sold out.
And that's after opening up another 11 tickets for skaters. It's sold out from the time he told me there were 11 spots till that. And that was on our way back from RCR.
Mm-hmm.
To the time I woke up in the morning, they were sold out. Again. So, yeah. It's going to be a hell of an event.
It's going to be fun.
I can't wait. I can't. For both of these.
Yeah.
This is going to be awesome. Coastal's the first of them. It's going to be a blast. I can't wait to work with these people again. Some of them see some new faces and quietly cheer on multiple leagues because I got a lot of friends in New England now. I think that's all I have to talk about. What about you?
I think I'm all talked out.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, then I guess it means that you've seen the sign on the side of the road that says you're exiting Derbyland. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe for more information about Greetings from Derbyland. I'm the voice of Virginia, KVD.
New Jersey Knight.
Good night, and thank you.
No, it could be just like, oh my god, he just keeps talking. Hand!